of the events of the decade just passed that most accurately put the turbulent 80s into perspective would take place in 1983, as a stunning young woman named Vanessa Willams became the first black Miss America, and then became the first Miss America, black or otherwise, to have photographs revealed of her, how shall I put this, having that proverbial tuna sandwich as she dined at the Y. The early photographs of Miss Williams and a white chick shocked a nation. Not so much because of the nature of the photographs, but because of the startling resemblance Miss Williams bore in them to James Brown, the long-haired soul singer. Once again, we've called upon United Nations Connecticut interpreter Johnson McKelvey to translate Miss Williams' remarks. She was asked what being Miss America would mean to her.
I hope for to be getting me a whole lot of money for with to buy stuff out. And then I wants to be getting into the movies. So I be posing for the films into the near future. Get back, signify. I already done started, see, by playing Johnny on the Pony with the white chick for DB Penthouse. Jump up, spread 'em. Good God. Sometimes I have to kiss myself.
A startling resemblance to the soul godfather.
It shocked the nation, Walter, and the next event to so capture the country would occur the very next year, 1984, aboard a New York City subway train. A meek, mild-mannered, some would say mousy man, burst to the headlines behind a smoking .38. Bernhard Getz, a celebrated subway vigilante. And who knew at the time that a fellow passenger's ghetto blaster was recording the entire episode that night as Bernhard sealed his place in the National Rifle Association's Hall of Fame.
Pick him up, mother...
Who, me?
No, Dwight Eisenhower. Yeah, you hopped up hockey jerk.
Oh, my. Are you wobbing me?
Well, we ain't saying. See, that way when all this come out in the post, ain't no way nobody could ever say that's what we was doing. Now hand over all your motherfucking money so we can buy.
Oh, my. Do you have a weapon?
Yeah. We got screwdrivers that look like ice picks.
Oh, okay. All I've got is a .38 Smith & Wesson Police Special. Instead of Subway Twain, why don't we play Soul Twain? Yeah, and you fellas can dance. Hey, you don't look so bad. Here's another. This is fun.
A night literally blown into this reporter's memory. I must
slow this.
Well, put it in the refrigerator. I'll get to it later. Finally, for this episode, Imus, who can forget that moment? 1987 it was. The building collapsed that crushed New York City disc jockey Don Imus to the consistency of an Aunt Jemima flapjack. Do you remember that?
Well, what are you talking about?
That terrible crash where that building fell on you, just destroyed you. Just crushed you into a flat like a pancake.
Oh, I wasn't crushed in any building collapse.
Well, I can dream, can I?
Imus in the morning.
Pack of Millers, 5 golden chains, 4 McDLTs, 3 French fries, 2 Kango caps, and a ticket for Rosie MC.
Joe, Merry Xmas, babe.
What?
Smell your nose.
I'm allergic to mistletoe.
Oh, yeah, right.
So I guess this holiday season, homos are back in fashion, huh?
What are you talking about?
Faggots throwing themselves on the floor at St. Patrick's. Merlin Olsen sending floral centerpieces to every linebacker he ever took a shower with. And you're washing the jock straps of the Fordham basketball team.
Well?
What is it with you? Have you no shame?
What?
I mean, I know gay pride is in, but must you flaunt your alternative lifestyle? You know, some people are not as enlightened as me about all this. Some people still get skeeved at the mental picture of two grown men smoking each other's peace pipe.
Oh, wait a minute here.
I mean, it's one thing to get some sort of sick satisfaction out of playing Chinese laundry with other men's underwear,
yeah,
but it's another thing to brag about it on a 50,000-watt radio station. You trying to tell me you're not a quiffo?
What? Huh?
No. Well, then let me ask you something. You could have made any kind of wager with the team, which, by the way, is known as the Rams.
Yeah.
No doubt the reason you went with them over to Seton Hall in the first place. You could have done anything. You could have said if you'd won, you'd wash their mascot, wash their cars, give give them cars. You could have promised them each a 1990 Porsche Francesa, but no. You wanted to do this. I can see it now. You sitting in some dank basement, dancing with Dan O'Sullivan's jock on your head, going, ring around the crotch, ring around the crotch. Then you get tired, you hang Andre McClendon's jock like a hammock and take a f***ing nap. What's next, Mr. Clean? You're going to shine their shoes with your You're going to give Damon Lopez a rub down? You're going to start writing love letters to the coach? My darling Nikki, just wanted to drop you a little note to say if your boys get into the finals, I'll rearrange their lockers and give them all a nice long hot oil massage. You f***ing stupid homo bastard!
Sam, come on.
Well, what am I supposed to hold it in?
Well, I don't know.
I'll explode.
Have you been here throughout the entire holidays?
No, I came here the day before Thanksgiving. Want some vodka?
No, I don't want any vodka.
All right.
So how are you?
Okay, how are you? Happy New Year, Mr. Chump.
It's a couple days ago, champ.
I know.
Oh, I see what you mean, though.
But you know, I've been up since Christmas, so...
I know you have. So who'd you spend Christmas with? The bartender here?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Yep, we built a tree over there in the corner. And I didn't have any presents, so I just tied a ribbon around my Johnson. So here, yeah, open this.
Well, come on, champ.
Bring me another drink.
Champ.
What?
Maybe we should try to walk this off.
What? Walk what off?
Well, I mean, you must have had 80 quarts of vodka.
Well, that's okay. I'm a big boy.
Yeah, you are. That's true.
But you know what I did? I did my New Year's revolution.
Well, and what is that?
Well, I'm going to go back to school and get my equivalency.
Right.
I'm going to quit smoking.
Gee, I didn't know you did smoke.
Well, I don't. But you have to have a couple easy ones in there. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to do the rest of them, right?
Okay.
I want to kill somebody in the ring this year. Because a lot of very famous fighters...
Oh, no, what?
Well, yeah, I want to kill somebody in the ring. I want to kill Jerry Cooney in the ring.
No, champion.
Yeah, no, I want him to die in the ring.
No.
And I want to be the guy that kills him. I want to hit him so hard that his head comes right off his body and flies up into the press box. And then I want all the guys in the press box to play soccer with it.
aren't New Year's resolutions supposed to be things to improve yourself? Or...
Yeah, okay. All right, then Don King.
You want to kill him?
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
Yeah, that candle head looking... Motherfucker. I never said that before. That feels good.
Yeah.
And I'm going to quit playing with my beef puppet.
With your beef puppet?
Yeah. Little Mikey.
Yeah.
You know, because, I mean, it's hard. I mean, yeah, that too, but I mean, it's also difficult.
Yeah, to stop playing with it.
Yeah, I mean, you're in the shower, you have a conditioner on your hair, you have 2-3 minutes to waste. What are you going to do?
I don't know, champ.
That's what I do.
I'm sure you do.
I spanked the weasel.
I'm missing a morning here with the champ. Happy New Year, champ.
Happy New Year to you. Did you see me dress up as Baby New Year's?
I didn't know, I didn't.
Well, look.
No, come on, champ, put your best
I like
on.
The diaper. Isn't that the best
yeah,
part?
That really is.
In the morning. Mario Biaggi. B, Lou Messicola. C, Al Di Meto. Which doesn't belong in Y, Al Di Meto. Well, all three are Italian politicians. Al Di Meto is not in jail yet. I'll pass that along to you right now, Will.
All right.
Let's begin now. Which okay. doesn't belong and why?
All right.
Question number one. A. Bob Crane. B. Sal Mineo. C. Imus in the morn.
I don't like the way this is going.
But I tell you what, C is the answer. So you struck out in one. While all three of these fellas are openly homosexual showbiz types, Bob Crane and Sal Mineo were beaten to death. Imus in the morn doesn't belong because he's a faggot in waiting. He's Neil Corbett, Will. All right, then.
This is really reprehensible.
We'll move on to question number two.
And repulsive.
Oh, for one we are now, boy. All right, which doesn't belong and why? A. Barbara Walters. B. Cindy Adams. And C. Mike Lupica. Which doesn't belong and why?
Well, I would say Lupica.
Well, I'll tell you what. It's Barbara Walters. While all three of these fellas are shallow media shills and pseudo-friends of despicable characters, Mike Lupica doesn't belong because he's not a Jew.
We should have stopped with the other one. The other one, while the other one wasn't funny, it had gone on long enough. We're at a point now.
Bing Bone Crawford.
Bernard, I'm begging you.
See, Imus in the morning.
Let's cut our losses here.
Wait a minute. This is pretty good.
All right, go ahead. Bing Crosby.
Bing Crosby.
Joan Crawford.
And C. Imus in the morning.
All right, why?
Which
why?
Doesn't belong in white.
Well, I would say Imus in the morning.
Wrong.
Why?
Well, all three have children who openly despise them. Bing Crosby doesn't belong because he's not a Jew.
Imus in the morning.
You're Kreskin, ain't you?
No, no, no. I mean, but you're the 80s guy. You
That's
know, you're,
right.
You're the one who kept screwing it up. Now, well, what are you doing back here?
Well, I'm just satisfying the terms of my contract, youngster. I mean, it's the right thing to do.
Now, you're telling me that Quaker Oats still wants you to...
Well, yeah. Well, look, it's a new decade, sonny. And Wilfred Brimley's turned over a new leaf. You can trust me on that.
Uh-huh. So there's going to be no oatmeal, you know what?
No, no, no. Look, it's the 90s. I'm an elderly man. I don't know what come over me back here in the 80s, but I've licked all that. You can bank on that.
I'll bet you have. All right.
Huh?
I'll take a run at it.
All right.
Quaker Oats 1990s campaign, take one. All right, go ahead, Mr. Brimley.
I'm Wilfred Brimley for Quaker Oats Oatmeal. You know, we're setting off on a brand new decade, the 1990s, and health is probably more important to folks now than ever before. We're going to be trying to take care of ourselves better, get more exercise, and eat better. And that's where oatmeal figures in. Now, if you was to make a New Year's list of resolutions, one of them ought to be to eat oatmeal because it tastes good and it can help reduce the cholesterol in your body. Not just keep it level, but bring it down. And at the same time, it can cure something that the doctors call sexual dysfunction. Not just help it now, cure it. And when you're 85 years old, believe me, that's a bonus for you for sure.
Damn it, Mr. Brimley.
Huh?
You said you'd turned over a new leaf and you weren't going to mention boners.
You know what? You got quite a mouth on you there, sonny. I didn't say a darn thing about a boner, did I, huh?
Well,
but now that you have, you're right. A hot bowl oatmeal can give you a zipper ripper that'd have Johnny Watt calling the suicide hotline. He wasn't already dead.
Yeah.
So, kids, if you want to get the 90s off to a healthy, natural start, you dive into a warm, mushy bowl of oatmeal. Why, you'll think somebody installed a garage door lift in your shorts. And tell Mom to forget that cereal bowl. Just say to her, Mom, just pour my hot steaming oatmeal into one of them tin horns left over from the New Year's Eve party. And then invite little Sally from next door to come over and blow it. Mom will probably swallow her tongue when she sees where you put your horn, but she'll get over that. And in the meantime, little Sally will get your New Year's off to a happier start than you had any idea was possible. Yes, sir, oatmeal in the 90s. It's the right thing to do.
Mr. Brimley, huh? What happened? I mean, where was the new leaf?
The new leaf? Oh, that. Well, I'll tell you. Let me stand up here.
No.
There you go. That'd be it right there. See it? Let me just flip it over there
Mr.
for
Brimley,
you.
Mr. Brimley, just leave it alone. No, don't
leave it. Look at that. It's flipping over by itself. Peek-a-boo.
Imus in the morning.
Here, Imus.
And how are you?
Cold.
I guess more important, how's Manuel?
He's a little depressed.
Mm-hmm.
He's a little upset.
Right.
However, he's much better now than he was when he was in the Vatican Embassy.
Right.
The paper nuncio apparently did not share his addiction to cocaine.
Right.
And that was, from speaking to the Generalissimo, that was one of the things that they used to get him into the helicopter.
Well, how did that work? Now, they used drugs to get him into the helicopter?
Well, kind of, you know, the carrot before the donkey.
Oh, I see, yeah.
They had a guy standing in the helicopter with a baggie filled with a white powder.
Right.
And waved the back and forth saying, Manny, this is for you. Unfortunately, Generalissimo Noriega was not aware until he had snorted half the bag that it was a baby laxative.
Baby laxative?
Which made the 3-hour flight to Miami a little unpleasant for the other passengers.
Well, I can imagine, yeah.
But he seems to be very alert and very curious about how he can get in touch with Jacobia Myers.
Jacobia Myers?
Well, obviously he's going to need some legal help.
Yes, he is.
He feels that he does not really stand that much of a chance of getting a fair trial here in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
But according to him, he still feels he's better off.
Let me ask you this, Mr. Sanchez.
See. Si.
When you talked to General Noriega,
si.
Did he say anything funny?
Did he say anything funny?
Yeah.
Well, actually, he gave me a quiz.
Uh-huh.
He actually said, I miss in the morning.
Right.
Joe Dropper.
Of course, as I pointed out, now that he's in the American penal system, he can get all the good drugs he wants.
This is very true.
And so sex. That's and sex.
Well, being in the penal system, what else would you get? That's funny enough for you?
I guess it's, unless you have something else.
Oh, I don't think so. I don't think so, Mr. 7.7.
Mr. Sanchez.
Mr. Hey, look at me, I'm number 3.
Thank you, Mr. Sanchez.
Mr. Hey, look, we finally beat the zoo. Mr. Hey, me and Marconi. Mr. Hey, Scott Myers, going to cost you more money. I don't care what the contracts say.
There isn't any more money, but when there is, we'll be the first to get it.
No, you'll be the one to get it.
Well, you know what I meant.
The rest of us will be going around going, please, give me a crumb, a quarter, anything.
It's 25 after 8 on the morning. And my way.
Ahora estamos cerca.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll make this clear. I just gave up because I was hurting. I had a real good time. I lived my life not in a shy way. I was the f***ing boss. I did it my way. George Bush, he kicked my ass just because I make fun of his honey. But not too long ago, the CIA, they give me money. I had a real good time, and every night was like a Friday. But now those days are gone, no longer my way. Regrets, I have had a few, but then again, too few to matter. I'm nuts, a psycho case, you heard it said, mad as a hatter. No more the dope and broads, the time has come to hit the highway. But hey, if I must go, I'll do it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not his own country, then he has not. The CIA, how they did search. Well, all the while, I was in church. The record shows, life really blows. But I did it my way.
I'm a